and welcome back to Astronaut. In this video, we're going to be talking about the first of Kepler's laws. Planets have elliptical orbits. I feel like an astronaut in what you know about rolling down in the deep. The law itself is quite simple. We've already stated it. Planets orbit a center of mass and an ellipse. The derivation becomes a bit more complicated. Let's start by just defining an ellipse. The shape of an ellipse is made up of points that are equal to a constant sum of their distance to two other points. These two base points are called the foci of an ellipse. When the two points are located at the same place, the ellipse becomes a circle. In the case of moving bodies, planets revolve around a star that is located at one focal point. Now, let's prove this by referring to some other well-known physical laws. The total energy of an orbit is equal to the kinetic energy, 1/2 mass times velocity squared, plus the potential energy, negative of the gravitational constant times the two masses divided by the distance. We can rewrite this in terms of polar coordinates. The velocity vector is made up of the distance and angle differential components, so we can rewrite the velocity component of the kinetic energy as r dot squared plus r squared times theta dot squared, where theta is the angle and r is the distance between the two masses. The angular momentum of the planet in radial coordinates will be m times r squared times theta dot. If we rewrite this in terms of theta dot, then the change in angle per time is equal to the angular momentum divided by r squared and m. This makes the angle equal to the integral of L divided by R squared and M. If we define a variable R inverse so that R inverse is equal to the inverse of R, we can rewrite the integral as L over M times R inverse squared dt. Now, R dot is equal to negative 1 over R inverse squared times dr inverse dt. So theta is equal to the integral of negative L over r dot dr inverse. We can rearrange our energy equation so that r dot squared is equal to 2 times E over m plus 2gm r inverse minus L squared divided by m squared times r inverse squared. Let's define two constants, L and E. We're going to set L equal to the angular momentum squared over g times the m's squared, and e equal to the square root of 1 plus 2 times e l over g times the m's. These constants may look chaotic now, but I promise they will help make our calculations cleaner in the end. R dot becomes l over m times e squared over l squared minus r inverse minus 1 over l squared to the 1/2 power. We can plug in r dot into our previous equation for theta, which simplifies to the inverse cosine of r inverse minus 1 over l divided by e over l. Finally, we can plug r back into r inverse and rearrange that the cosine of theta equals r inverse minus 1 over l divided by e over l. Solving for r, we find that the distance between the two masses is l divided by 1 plus e cosine theta. This is the equation for an ellipse in polar coordinates, where L is the semi-lattice rectum and E is the eccentricity of the ellipse. Okay, that derivation was a bit much, I understand. So feel free to reach out to me if you have any questions, or just rewatch this video again and work it out yourself. Working out yourself is always the best way to understand. All right, great. Thank you guys. It's slow motion, yeah. I feel-